Welcome to MATLAB Tech. Here we discuss about MATLAB and how to build different models in MATLAB. Basically, here we do implementation of our practical concept using MATLAB's understanding, and we usually build different models. And here we try to understand the concepts using different analogies that is present in our real life. And here in this episode we will talk about different components of state flow and how they are being related to our practical environment, and how we can basically understand and correlate between those two. We will talk about this. To be updated to my channel and to see the just uploaded video, please do subscribe to my channel and press on the bell icon so that you will not miss my updated videos to get the basic understandings of state flow and all related things to that. Basically, here we talk about how MATLAB is being understood and how it is being implemented in industrial domain, so that we will have a clear understanding not only on the basics but also on the how to implement those things in a practical scenario, and how we can crack interviews as well. In this episode we will discuss more about what is the about the introduction into a chart, how a chart operates in a Simulink, and what is a chart. Then we will go into different components of state, and we will discuss what is a state and what are the different subcomponents that is present in the states in state flow chart. Then we will go into the junction, what is a junction and how it is being implemented in state flow. Then we will go into transition concepts, what are the different transitions and how they behave in the state flow. Then we will try to understand different concepts of functions in the state flow, that is three types of functions that are present in the state flow, that is state flow functions, MATLAB functions, that is MScript function, and Simulink functions. Then we will go into the concept of boxing, and then we will go into the concept of history block, what is the use of history block, and then we will go into the understanding of Simulink state flow data dictionary. Then we will go into the understanding of what are the different decompositions that is present in the state flow, and then how we can do group subchart for the states present in the state flow. Now we need to discuss what is a chart. It is the top level representation of a logic in which interacts with the Simulink model, and it receives the required information from the top level, that is from the Simulink model, and all components of the state flow chart are present inside this chart. And all the logics that we implement will implement inside this chart. So we can correlate this scenario to something like a human interacting with the computer. As a human, we see what is being typed on the screen, and based on the representation on the screen, we try to correlate what we need to type that is being processed with the logic that is present in the brain of the human. So like the same way, here the chart will receive some input from Simulink model, then it will try to process it, what is the next step it should take based on the logic, then it will give some output into the Simulink model, then the Simulink model will try to process what is need to be done, that is according to the basic physics and all those things, then it will give an output, that output is being received with the help of the chart, and that chart again process, and the process, whole process will repeat again and again, and the logic is being implemented. This is somehow similar to a human operating a computer. When we try to build our state flow chart, then it is called a controller modeling, and when we are trying to develop a Simulink model, then it is called the plant modeling. There are two different teams in every organization that will design controller model, and that will be defining one plant model. Plant model is done based on the basic physics and involving first principle analysis that we analyze in the actual system, and we try to represent it in the mathematical format. And in this way, we are only representing the physical phenomenon that is happening inside the plant or in the system with the help of Simulink model. Then we try to control it with the help of the chart model. In this chart model, we implement different logical things to control the plant. Let us understand what is a state and what are the different components of the state. There are different components. There are around 6 components that are present in the state, and how a state look like, it looks like this in MATLAB state flow. And then what are the different components that we need to see in the state flow? Here we will also try to understand the things with the help of different analogy. As you can see, there is first state is entry state. It executes when there is a entry of the activeness into the state. Means when a state get active first, then first these statements will be executed. As you can see here, entry will assign x is equal to 1. So as you can also see, there is a man entering into the house. Then at the entry state, he need to open the door. That is the first entry activity when he is entering into the house. He will open the door, then he will enter inside the house. Now we need to look into what is a during state. When the man is inside the house, he will be doing some activity like watching TV and washing clothes and all those things. So that will happen when he is only inside the state. That is the during state. As you can see in this block, we are seeing that in during state, x is being updated or incremented by one value. X is equal to x plus 1. Here we are incrementing the value of x by 1. Yeah, as you can see. Now the next state is the exit state. The exit state happens when the man is exiting out of the house. Then he need to also close the door when he is exiting out of the house. Then at this scenario, he will do some activity. And as you can see here in exit, we are assigning a value. What is the current value of x? Addition to that, we are adding 1 and assigning it to y. This activity will happen when we are exiting the house. Next comes what is a bind state. Bind is usually not represented as a state, but it can help to bind one state with some particular event or data. Suppose then it will broadcast the event or data into the children state. Now we need to understand what is a children state and what is a parent state. Suppose this is the state that we are present in, then here the gear is called the parent state, and the first, second, third is called the children state. So when a bind activity is being attached to this one, to parent state, then it will be broadcasted to its children state. As you can see, now we need to look into what is an on event and what is an on message state. So when the state is active and it receives some broadcast event, then it is called an on event state. Then in this case, as you can see, the house as you can see the house, when there is a pipe disconnected, then the water will be throughout the house. Then this person inside the house need to fix this one, otherwise the water will be spread throughout the house. This is called an event-based activity that is happening, and in this case the event is the breakage of the pipe, and the activity that is happening is connection establishment between those two ends of the pipe through the person. So here the person is doing some activity due to the event that is happening inside the house. So this is also correlated to, in a same way, an event activity inside the state. When an event is active as well as the state is active, means when the person is inside the house as well as the pipe is broken, then only he can fix the water leakage inside the house. Now we will look into what is the on message state activity. It executes when the message is available inside the state. It happens when it is more similar to when we are working inside the house and we receive a phone call or a message inside the house, then we need to either exit from the house or we need to do some activity inside the house. Suppose a friend is coming and he texted you that he is coming, and then you need to prepare some food for him. So at that instant you will go to the kitchen and start cooking. This is more similar to an on message event. That is on message activity. That is, you are getting a message from your friend that he is coming. Then the activity that is being related to that one is you are starting cooking, and when he comes, then you will be ready with the food and have the dinner or lunch with him. In this case, we came across one concept called children's state and parent state. As you can see in the figure here, here is the parent state, and the first, second and third are the children's state. Here the activity will be like, when we are entering inside the gear state, then what is all present inside the gear state, all statement will be executed. Then control will come first into the first state, because we have a default transition that is present in here. So this represents that when this state being active, then we first go into the first state. Then from first state we can go into the second as well as the third state in the sequential manner as represented with the arrow, with the conditions that is present in the diagram. So here as we can see, gear is our parent state, and the first is the first child state, second is the second child state, and third is the third child state, and fourth is the fourth child state. And all the sequence will happen in a sequential manner based on the conditions that is happening between first, second, third and fourth. They will interact, the children will interact.